Hi! There are multiple patterns that allow us to handle unsubscription from RxJS stream when any component, directive, or anything else is getting destroyed. One of the most popular patterns is using the takeUntil operator along with RxJS subject. So when the component is getting destroyed, the subject emits a value, and this value makes the takeUntil operator to complete the stream, right? Please take a look at this piece of code for a couple of seconds and try to answer if this code will cause a memory leak or not. Ready? So, 3, 2, 1. I destroy the component and it is leaking. My name is Metro Mzhensky, and today we are going to talk about different ways how to handle unsubscriptions in our Angular applications and how to avoid pitfalls like the one you saw a minute ago. The mistake I intentionally made in this code snippet I see over and over again, and that was the reason why I decided to record this video. What do you think could be the issue here? Why is this nested subscription inside the SwitchMap operator leaking despite we use the takeUntil operator? Well, I will tell you. The reason is the order of operators. If you move the takeUntil operator below the SwitchMap, only then we will get the behavior we expect, and only then we get rid of the memory leak. It is not a bug. It is the way how operators like takeUntil work. And this is the pitfall you have to know when you work with these kind of operators. And here I mean operators like takeUntil, take, take while, first, and other operators that complete the stream. The thing is that when operator completes the stream, it makes the operators above perform the teardown logic, which does different cleanup stuff. For example, the teardown logic of the SwitchMap operator will unsubscribe from the inner observable. And this is the reason why the SwitchMap operator isn't leaking right now. But if you move it below the takeUntil operator, then the teardown logic will not be executed for the SwitchMap because it goes after the takeUntil one. Okay, but what about the brand new operator that was introduced with Angular 16 called takeUntilDestroyed? Maybe this operator will solve the problem. Well, not actually, it doesn't solve this problem, because the takeUntilDestroyed operator utilizes the same pattern and uses the same takeUntil operator under the hood. It is just extracted into a separate function or operator in order to make it easier to reuse it. So if you use this takeUntilDestroyed operator, you have to also make sure that you use it in a proper place. So if you use this pattern in order to handle unsubscriptions in your Angular application, then the general recommendation would be to place takeUntil plus subject or takeUntilDestroyed operator in the end of the operator chain. However, there are always exceptions, like basically everywhere in RxJS, but still, there is a group of RxJS operators that are emitting values right before the stream is completed. For example, some of those operators are last, take last, toArray, reduce, count, max, and minimum, and maybe some others. Please let me know in the comments if I forgot something. But if you use one of those operators, then keep in mind that they have to be placed even after the takeUntil plus subject or takeUntilDestroyed operators, because otherwise they will not be working as you expect. Regarding other operators that can complete a stream, it might be a little bit tricky because you have to explicitly check if moving such an operator will not break your logic. For example, if I move the takeOne operator to the end of the operator chain, then my stream will be completed after the first polling cycle, which is not what I'm waiting for, right? But if I move it above, then my long-living polling subscription will be properly working. But again, If nothing completes the polling subscription, then probably you might have problems and you have to somehow complete the stream using something like takeUntilDestroyed operator or any other approach. And only after that you will get the desired behavior and get rid of memory leak. Because in this configuration, the takeOne operator instructs how many value emissions need to be taken from the closest source observable that is located upstream and not for the whole stream in total. So if after this operator you will not explicitly handle this long living subscription, then you will get a memory leak. But what about the classic unsubscribe that we can do inside the ng on destroy lifecycle hook? Well, in this case, there is no any pitfalls and it works as you expect. The only disadvantage here is that you have to do it for every subscription. There is also a way to create an instance of subscription and add all the subscriptions to it. Then you just unsubscribe once from the, so to say, master subscription, and it will perform unsubscription for all subscriptions that were added to this main one. However, I personally find the best way to manage unsubscribing using the async pipe. It is very clean, it is very safe because it will automatically unsubscribe or kill the subscription every time when the corresponding view is destroyed. But it has also some disadvantages. The async pipe is available only in templates, and if you have to manage the subscription in some Angular service or directive, then you will not be able to use this async pipe. But is there even better way? The way that has all the benefits from async pipe and can be used everywhere, like in service or in the Angular directive? And my answer is yes. And the solution is converting the observable to a signal by using the brand new RxJS interop API. It is an Angular developer preview right now, so be careful, it is not production ready yet, but in Angular 16 you can already play around with it. To convert an observable to a signal, you have to use the helper function called toSignal, and that's it. Since this function returns a signal, you can go and use it everywhere where you need. When it happens that the component, service, directive, or pipe is destroyed, the toSignal function will care about unsubscription from this RxJS stream. Because check out the source code of this function. Under the hood, it injects and uses the destroy ref provider. I covered destroy ref provider in my previous video, you can check it out later, but in short, this provider allows to register some cleanup logic which will be executed before the corresponding scope is destroyed. In my case, by scope I mean the component. Then here you can see that it subscribes to the observable that we provided as an argument for the toSignal function, and it creates the reference to the subscription. Then here you can see below the cleanup logic is registered for the destroy ref provider, and inside this cleanup logic we unsubscribe from the created subscription, and again it will happen when the corresponding scope like component, directive, service or something else is destroyed. So later when this API will become stable, we will get a really powerful replacement for the async pipe, and it is awesome. Alright guys, that's it. I hope you learned something new from this short video, and if it is your first time on my channel and if you like how I explain Angular stuff, then please subscribe to this channel and go and check my other videos. There are a lot of really unique and in-depth tutorials about Angular. And also, if you want to learn how to build really complex and custom form controls like complex dropdowns, and if you want to learn everything about Angular forms, then check out my video course. The link will be in the video description. Otherwise, don't forget to leave your comments, subscribe to my other social media profiles, and I wish you productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.